The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Pete in Long Island. Hey, Pete, what's going on?
Hey, Tom. Good evening, and I want to give you a big thank you. Last night I called for your advice, and you gave me such wonderful and correct information. If you remember, I was short three goals by
yes.
NEM, AU, and AEM.
Right.
And based on your opinion, you've been right on the mark with this. Boy, it was wonderful, Tom. I got to be honest with you. It's unbelievable what you're doing for your radio listeners.
Well, I appreciate the call, man. Thank you so much.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. It's a TGIF, folks. Let's make it a great one. Surround yourself with people who believe you can. Dan Zabra. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 273, NASDAQ off 59, S&P's down 28, gold contract up $20, trading at $1,137 an ounce, silver up 15 cents at $15.13 an ounce, platinum down $3 at $9.80 an ounce, copper down 7.5 pennies at $2.38 a pound, light sweet crude down $2.05 at $45.15 a barrel, bonds 10-year up 22 ticks, 128. 30-year up 2.5, almost 3 points at 155.27. King dollar up 383 ticks, 95.06. The euro is down 91 at 113, and the yen is trading at 119.84. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? It's going to be a nasty close out here, folks. So, yesterday, you run by what we have happening here. Fed doesn't go up on rates. Fed brings the whole deal down to the aspect that now we got to look at emerging markets. We got to look at China. All of the above. The bottom line, folks, is that Yellen blinked. The market's looking at it and saying, okay, what else is happening out here? I suspect that we're not going to see rates higher, probably 6, 7, 8 months, maybe a year, who knows. Bottom line, markets, you're coming down with volume on the S&Ps. You're down 27 right now in the futures. The low of the day out here is 1944 with 1949.50. I suspect, folks, we're actually going to blow that low out coming in for the next hour. So where are we heading? Well, yeah. Your high volume swing low from the 24th is 1823. First level it's going to go after is the 1890. So you're talking about another $50 down, and I suspect that's going to be fast, furious, and all of the above. We take a look at the NQs, the NASDAQ futures, and inside the NASDAQ, which is really a trip, is that you have Adobe, which was down $2 last night, by the way. It's up $1 now. Amazon is up $2.77. That had been up like $5. So you have a little strength inside the NASDAQ, but it's not going to be enough to save the NASDAQ. So NASDAQ, what do we have with NASDAQ? The NQs right now are running out at 43.16. The low for the day is 42.99. I expect you're going to go after that low. What I expect we're actually going to see, we're going to blow these lows out from the morning, folks. On the NASDAQ futures, you can picture about 42.87. And if we go back to the E-minis here for a second and you take a look at this next hour, what we're dealing with on the E-minis, yes. Right now we're trading at 1948.50. And this game on here for 1938. So we're down 28. We can be down 38 in a heartbeat. Down 38 would run the Dow. We're down 280. Would run the Dow down about 250, 260. Volume-wise out here, it's going to be heavy volume because what you have happening is that we're on option expiration. Bottom line, folks, option expiration has the potential to get higher price, has the potential to get lower price. Bottom line, what we're doing is that we're going lower, have an expansion of volume. That we're into the 24th, the trading from the 24th. The numbers I gave you weren't the lows of the 24th. The reason I haven't given you those lows yet is because you had the NASDAQ futures, they were down limit, okay, on the 24th. So then that number's real. The S&P future number is real. There's plenty of ETF structures that are not real. So if you're looking at your charts or you're looking at your equities, you want to use the 25th. Use the 25th first. First thing I suspect we're going down to, though, we're going to get down to the lows of September 1st. Gold contract. What do we have with gold? Bottom line. And this is where this is going to get really wild, folks, okay? You know, I'm coming after the 700th edition of my gold report. Now, that's 13 and a half years. In those years, you know, we were lucky. We caught gold on the way up. We caught it at 282. We rode it really well up to highs. That being said, my take, whether on CNBC or just in general, is that, okay, you're at highs. You're going to take your bread. It was a 2-to-1 ABC structure on the way up. The extension was pretty amazing. Bottom line, you have the correction all the way down. Devastates everything, right? Bottom line, folks, you're going to see we're at 1137. This run will take, it's going to take folks by surprise. And this is why. Well, first off, technically it's set up, okay? It's set up at this point. It's only set up to get about 1232. How we get to 1232 will and can set it up to get into the 1392 area from the highs of March of 2014. Now, you get that going, guess what? Then you get the run all the way up to 1800, 1794. So this is going to be a trip watching this shake out. And where I'm going, so that's the technical setup. The fundamental setup is really cool. The fundamental setup, folks, is that now the bottom line is that the Federal Reserve cares about the whole rest of the world now. Well, the world is screwed, folks. That's a simple one. Europe is going down the tubes. Asia's already gone down the tubes. Our markets are going to go down the tubes. This is like, okay, we're not going up in December. And when I'm looking at the markets, the markets, as I said many times, they don't go up forever or down forever. You know, this will be a nasty market 2, 3, 4 months, whatever that is. Okay, then you have to repair the market. You have to do it. Bottom line, that puts the Fed in my way out. I'm talking about way out, too. They're talking about next June, next September, whatever. Now, let's go take a look at the bonds, because what is going to happen, I suspect, is this. The bonds are not ready to trade just yet, but I suspect because we had two separate downdrafts with volume that they're going to be ready. Okay, and this is where it stands right now. We had a high volume spike on the 4th of September. That was 128.04. We hit 128 today. The spike is up at 129.10. You got to let it go up there, but I suspect that bonds can be traded up at those much higher levels. Well, listen, you just wait for it to come in. You see if the volume comes in. The volume doesn't come in and does the test. Field day. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We're getting right back. We're coming right back. Dow's down 270. NASDAQ off 56.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit tfnn.com.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, two times currency hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls. Now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. You get the Dow down 289, NASDAQ's up 62, S&Ps are down 29, and you're going to see some heavy pressure coming into this close, folks. You not only have option expiration happening, you're on a Friday. You have a market that has spun quite a few people around, and you had a market that no doubt when the Fed came out and didn't raise rates yesterday, you got to remember that the market initially went up $180. And what that does ASAP is does what? Bottom line, the buy-in was there, and I can understand why the buy-in was there, because fundamentally I think that, okay, it's been free money forever. We're going topside. Well, bottom line is that there's more problems out here. It's a valuation deal. That's all this is. This is a sell-off, valuations, it's a correction, it's all of the above. But because we haven't had one for so long, that's where the nastiness comes in with the whole deal, you know. And if it's anything like the first leg down, man, was insane. I suspect, you know, you're going to get a good feeling of the second leg down pretty quick, meaning today. When you come to Lowe's, okay, so let's tell you here. I'm going to show you this and talk about it if you're in the car and you're not in Tiger TV at the same time, okay? When you start pressing Lowe's and you had a nice counter trend bounce. A lot of it has to do with how big the counter trend bounce is, too. And this morning, we had a nice one. You get a counter trend bounce like that, that is the ultimate of when they take out lows, they take them out in an extraordinary way, okay? Bottom line, that's what I expect you're going to see in the next 45 minutes as we come in. Now, let's go over to our man, Mr. Steve Rhodes, folks. And don't forget, Steve has an outstanding program right here at TFNN. Every trading day, 1 to 2 Eastern Standard Time. Also has a great newsletter, Mastering Probability. You can get that newsletter by coming over to our website at TFNN. You go into newsletters, go into trading newsletters. You see Mastering Probability right there. You can test drive it 30 days absolutely free. What's happening, brother?
Just loving the trading. Loving the trading.
Yep. It's fast, furious, and, you know, this wide price spread. It's a beautiful thing.
No, absolutely. You know, one of the things I just heard you briefly mention bonds, and it sounds like you're getting ready, preparing to short bonds. So I want to share with you and our listeners and our viewers some really cool tools. So for all those folks that trade either TLT or the TBT, The first chart that I've got on my screen was something that I took a snapshot of a couple of hours ago. So just a blank chart out here. You know, blank charts don't have a ton of meaning to us. But what are the tools that that folks can apply to? And this is the T-bond futures contract. One of the things that they can apply to it are two exponential moving averages, the 19 and the 39. And they're really cool moving averages for what they do when they actually converge. So if you take a look at the red arrows that are on my screen right now, that shows the convergence of those two moving averages. Typically, when price is either moving down or up, once we see the crossover of those two moving averages, price typically starts to slow down. And not only does it slow down, eventually price will come back and try to test the upper boundary or the lower boundary, depending on whether price is moving lower or higher, will try to come back in and hold that area. And if we take a look at where bonds are right now, or we take a look at where that, and we'll post a current chart here in just a moment. What I want folks to realize, I'm going to share two different tools that people can use, because if in fact, like back here in the time frame of June, it looks like May and June, price came back. We saw a little crossover in the early part of May. Price came back, it tested that level, held as resistance. Price continued on lower. So we got the pause. Price came back, tested it, went ahead, moved lower. You know, today, and if price is able to break right through that area, we saw a nice wide-ranging bar back here in the end of August where price came back, tested that area, and prices obviously had gone down since. But what's most important for people to take a look at is what's going on right now. And there's also another tool that I want to share before we go back to that chart. And that is, if people apply a stochastic oscillator to their chart and they use the settings of 14, 3, and 3, so it's a little slight difference in the oscillator. What I want them, and I also want them to go ahead and set the, instead of an 80-20 rule, just take a look at the midpoint line being 50. And one of the cool patterns that exists out here with regard to that oscillator specifically is a divergence pattern, where you either have price moving lower, as it did back in May, but yet that oscillator is making a higher low out there, or where price is moving higher, as it did back in the September-August time frame, yet the oscillator was making a lower high out there. In fact, what we had take place here a couple of days ago was we had price moving lower and we had just a slightly higher oscillator reading. And what's really cool about this chart is when you have those types of divergent patterns, they help you identify at least short-term or longer-term lows and highs inside of the market. And what's really nice, you always talk about the market squawking, walking, and talking. It does a fourth thing out there often, which is paint Japanese candlesticks. And when you get those Japanese candlesticks, those either those bullish or those bearish reversal signals, what I want the people to focus on right now is the fact that the yesterday's price action, where we had already had price moving lower, we had the divergent pattern with the stochastic out there. Yesterday's candle formation created that three river morning star. So it's a bullish reversal signal that's inside the market. If we take a look at where we were as of maybe about 5 minutes ago, we can see that price has already risen above that moving average line out there. And that says that price, so we have two sets of patterns to help us identify that price is either going to stall, come back, test an area of what in this case here should have been resistance. If it fails at resistance, price goes ahead and moves higher out there. So this is a set of tools that folks can use. It's just two moving average lines, 19 and a 39 exponential moving average, and this stochastic 14-3-3. And if they go out and take a look at the divergent patterns, it'll assist them in their trading. So I thought that would be a cool thing to share. And like awesome. You were saying, so
you know what happens too, which if you, or Friday, if you can flip that on a weekly, what you're going to see, folks, is that that's going to be a beautiful hammer and a nice long one too, you know.
Yeah. Yeah. So, you know, so it says now this doesn't help us to identify where price heads to. Then you've got to use different tools.
It's going to head to the highs.
Yeah, like you're saying. Yeah, it could head up to those highs. Look, it was only a 0.618 retracement level. So it could even be an A to B equals CD to the upside. So a number of different patterns that are unfolding. But the important one, or the important ones, are for our listeners and viewers to be able to spot when the markets are about to turn. And that way it can help them in managing their trade or getting into a trade and so forth. Now, One of the things that you and I have talked about over the past month here is the uncanniness of the market in its following along the glide path and the pattern of both the top from 2007 and 2000. And in again, folks that are looking at this chart out here, the beginning point for each of these lines are basically at market tops. The red arrow shows where we're at as of yesterday. So the market was supposed to make a high. This was so uncanny about what the market did yesterday.
Yeah.
And then sell off towards into next week. Into next week, maybe the end of the month out here. So my take is if the ES Mini closes below 1954, that's the message of the markets.
Message of the markets, beautiful thing. And you can listen to that every day, folks. 1 o'clock right here at TFNN, tfnn.mobi. Steve, thanks so much, man. You have a great weekend, safe weekend. Look forward to show Monday.
Take care.
Thank you. And folks, you can get Steve's newsletter by coming over to our website at TFNN, going to newsletters, trading newsletters. You can see the Master in Probability right there. Check it out. We're going to be coming right back, folks.
This coming Tuesday, September 22nd, Tom O'Brien will publish the 700th issue of his weekly newsletter, The Gold Report. It's amazing to think that Tom started his newsletter over 13 years ago when gold was trading under $300 an ounce. To celebrate the 700th issue, you can sign up right now at a 20% savings off the regular monthly price, and you can lock in that low rate for as long as you remain a subscriber. The Gold Report is Tom's weekly newsletter covering the gold market as well as a variety of gold mining equities. The Gold Report is published every Tuesday afternoon with a market update sent out to subscribers on Monday mornings. Tom will walk you through what's going on in the gold and metals market each week, as well as providing specific buy and sell recommendation on the mining equities themselves. Now is the perfect time to sign up for the Gold Report. The 700th issue is published Tuesday, and that's when this sale ends, so act now.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow is down 288. You get the NASDAQ off 63. S&Ps are down 29. If we take a look inside the indices themselves, strength versus weakness, you have zero winners inside the Dow. Apple is the leader on the way down. Apple is the leader, and that's down 10 cents. The laggard, Merck is off 177. Caterpillar is down 228. You get Goldman Sachs down 547, and Exxon is off $2.05. If we do go over to those financials and look at those financials, We'll start with Goldman Sachs. And what you're going to see is this. The trading day of August 24th, folks, okay? We're into it. And right now, Goldman is showing that you're not only into it, but you're going to go to the bottom of this day. It's down $5. You've done 2.2 million shares. Now, check this out. This is intense. On the 24th of August, we only did 1.6 million. You're coming into a swing point of 179, and you did 1.1. They're getting out of banks so quick they can't see straight. Those banks are going to go down to the lower end, more than likely break the August 24th level. That's a heads up in a huge way. Inside the NDX 100, this is what we have, strength versus the weakness. The strength inside the NDX 100 is Adobe. You got to look at Adobe, too. This is a trip. So last night, Adobe came up with numbers when we were on the air. The numbers were good, and Adobe was down $2. It was like a total mind blower. Well, what happened this morning, Adobe, in a bad market, opens up, and it opens at 78.45, and boom, immediately goes to 84.90. Now, what you're going to have with Adobe is this. You have juice inside the structure, but you know what you've done? This is like really crazy, man. This little baby, okay, went into the three black crows that were coming down. And you see that phenomenon, and that is nuts, folks, okay? Bottom line, what does that set up? That sets up the Adobe is going to go all the way back to its lows of 71.34 and very well will break them. That is over the top. There's no two ways about it. So taken away from the NDX 100, what do we have? Vertex Pharmaceutical, that's down $10, trading at 124. You get Micron down 98. You get Western Digital down 470. And you have Seagate Technology down $2.45. The volume is going to be massive today. Inside the NYSE, we've already done $974 million. That's saying we're going to come in with $1.5, $1.6 billion. Inside the NASDAQ composite, what we have is that we have 1.6 already. That's going to come in at 2.5, 2.6. What we don't have, this is what's just absolutely amazing, too. There's still no fear in this marketplace. There was euphoria yesterday. We had a plus 1,600 tick. Just to give you an idea, I want to show you something here. What a plus 1,600 tick does is, and the tick is predicated, folks, on the NYSE, okay? So the way that you establish ticks, or they get established, is you have buyers and sellers, and when you have an uptick, what happens is that you take all the stocks that are trading in the NYSE, you take the ones that are bought on bids versus offers, and then you subtract the ones that are on bids versus offers, first off. Well, when you get a plus 1600 tick, it means that within 1 minute, okay, everyone was buying stocks, but not on the bid. They were buying them on the offer. That is about as extraordinary as you can get. The last time that we got a tick that was that high, okay, was in August 10th of 2011, okay? Bottom line, most times when you get a large uptick like that, it's normally the next day that you give it up. But when I saw this come across, it just happened that it come across right before I was getting on the air, which was sweet because we're sitting there trading anyway. Bottom line, we saw what happened. It gave it up immediately. And the reason is this. That's the technical setup, how they work. The fundamental setup goes like this. The fundamental setup is that people that were short were closing. People that were long and wanted to get longer were in there buying. And then what ends up happening? Well, then who do you sell to? Okay. Then your next step after that goes like this, folks. The largest downdrafts in the marketplace come after spikes in the market. If you get my daily newsletter and you've got it in the past, you know that we're always looking for spikes. I particularly am always looking for a spike. I've seen what happens with spikes. The market loves spiking. And this is on the downdraft too, by the way, okay, when you're making lows. What you do is you grind, and then boom, then the spike happens, and then bang, it gives it all up. And what that's all about The market is just like us. It's all about energy. It's energy as breathing back and forth. The last gasp is the name of the game, you know? And where is the last gasp coming from? And when you see those last gaps in the marketplace, that's when you get real action. In this particular case, what we have, and we already had, you already have all these high volume swing lows that are hanging out here. And we're gonna go after them right now, because what the market has just done, you know, we're at the 20th, 17th, we're gonna be back on the 19th, I'll be back on the 20th. So you can see that when we came down on the 24th, you know, you've been rallying for 3 weeks. You've just broke the whole small uptrend that was there, because the uptrend that was there was a decent uptrend. Bottom line, you just broke that down, and what do? We broke it down with conviction. So what does that set up? That sets up that we're gonna now go after the swing lows. Sad but true. But, you know, what you wanna pay attention to is that the Federal Reserve, bottom line, is paying attention to markets, paying attention to the rest of the world. That to me, get your head wrapped around. You don't have to be short the market. You can be out of the market, get stops in, but get your head wrapped around commodities and real estate. Because what's going to happen here, folks, okay, is we have inflation out here. I wouldn't say they're worrying about the wrong thing. I think the market's overvalued anyway. But the bottom line is that now, you know, the wizard has no curtain. The guy running down the street has no pants. Well, guess what? That's the Federal Reserve right now. And in spades, too. I mean, in spades. Because you know what? They probably should worry about that. But now, my take is that they're going to worry about everything. And if I've learned one thing in life, if you think too much, you're history, man. One of the biggest problems I've seen in the world, you know, is thinking about one thing too much. And the Fed is thinking about one thing too much. But hey, we'll see where it shakes out. I suspect commodities, I suspect that's where you want to be. Real estate, that's where you want to be. Real assets is where you want to be. And that's going to get intriguing, because, of course, the commodity market has got toasted. But guess what? When it gets toasted, that's when you want to be. Today out here, you got gold's up 1.8%. You got wheat up 1%. Cocoa's up 1%. You got silver up 0.8%. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. We'll come back. We'll look at oil. Oil's taking a beating. We'll look at oil and see how that's going to come back into that $42, $41 area. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. Dow down 290. NASDAQ down 66. S&Ps are off 31. We're going to be right back, folks.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a 2-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per $100,000 investment, with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income, much like a CD.
For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now. The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. You get the Dow down 310, NASDAQ's off 70, S&P's are down 33, and you're going to see that expansion coming into this close, folks. Gold's up 20, you got silver up 17. Well, let's go to King Dollar. So King Dollar, let's take a look at this baby, because what King Dollar did do, DX, okay, DXZ5. So King Dollar gets down to a price point, DXZ5, okay. King Dollar gets down to a price point of 94.19, and we're into the trading that was generated out here on the 24th. The top of that trading is 95.27. The bottom of it, 92.85. And you got down there, you know, with light volume. So what King Dollar is going to try to do now is get into the lows of, let's see, of the 10th. The lows of the 10th are 95.57. We'll see how they try to attack that area. You know, because what you did do out here today, you rejected the bar that was generated out here on the 24th. What I expect you're going to see is that you're going to, you know, you'll do that bounce and no juice whatsoever, because King Dollar has shown that it hasn't been able to hold price. What King Dollar couldn't do, it couldn't even get to its swing point, which is just insane. I mean, it didn't make any sense that King Dollar couldn't get to a swing point. But guess what? You have a huge seller. That's huge seller, folks, is China. That's what's going on. And they're basically selling dollars to basically keep, and they're selling euros too, in order to keep their yuan from really imploding. You take a look at some of the high volume stocks. The whole market, of course, is down out here today, but the high volume stocks, there's not one green stock here. You have Freeport MacMoran, they're coming out with a secondary that's down $1.30. Intel's down 77. You got Wells Fargo off 127. JP Morgan's off 176. Let's go look at JP Morgan for a second. So JP Morgan, the financials are really going to take it on the chin. And the financials, it's really wild. The financials are always the last ones to fall apart. And man, then when they fall apart, they're the ones that really take the market south. And there you go. See, okay, they're selling the financials. JP Morgan is down $1.76, which is not a huge deal. Volume, though, is monster, folks. 24 million already. And the high of the 24th, which is a benchmark, is $62.92. You're already $2 into that level. So what does that set up? Well, it at least sets up the low of the 25th. The low of the 25th is 59.73. You know, we'll see what kind of volume we come into it. I suspect it's going to get lower than that. They had a tick at 50 bucks on the 24th. The thing that's really going to be bizarre is if, you know, when you come into a Friday on a bad week, it's real possible that this come Monday morning is going to be worse, because what you can get very quickly is a limit down market. It's not hard. We've already got it. And once you're in a limit down market, by the way, you can get one, two, three of these very quickly. I think the biggest one I was ever in was, I believe, in 07. We had three, and one day we had three limit down moves. And what happens with a limit down move is that you go limit down. If you want to close a position, meaning that in this case that was, you know, the market was going south. So if you were short, you could buy a contract, but that's it. Can't sell anything more. Then I believe it's a half. They were closed for a half hour. They open up again. It's either half hour, 40 minutes. Open up again. Bang, the thing went limit down again. Then it went limit down again. That was like unbelievable. Bottom line is that they're problematic markets if you're trapped in that market, no doubt. And well, even when you're trading, you want to make sure that you've been in one before. Let's put it that way. Because what you don't want to do if you're trading back and forth is that you get in the limit down market. Like I was saying to my son this morning, I bought the open, kept the bounce, sold it again. But if you do that, what you better make sure you do is that as soon as you go long, what I do is if I go long in the futures market and I'm biased to the downside, like 8,000%. But if you're trading both sides, which I do in a market like this, what you do is as soon as you go the side that you think that, you know, you're just trading the counter trend, you put a stop right underneath it. You just give it a point or 2 points. Because on bounces in a market like we have, they should be fast and furious. That's how they come in, you know. So we'll see whether this market stays down the 300. See, the 300 point, that's a psychological deal. But the way that this S&P's already hit, They try to hold it under the 300, because the 300, you know, people come back, you know, saying the Dow's down over 300. That's a problem on a Friday afternoon. Thus far, the S&Ps are at the 1944. And if they can get them over 1944, the headlines won't be as bad as they could be. I suspect, however, that we're going to be somewhere around that 1937. And that's quite a way down from where we are right now. You're going to see a lot more selling as we come into this close. You know, it's wild too, folks. This is the last day that the futures are going to trade to quarter past four. So the future market trades to quarter past four. Starting this Monday, next Monday, everything closes at 4 o'clock. So it's going to be wild. I don't think it's going to make much difference, you know, because the reality is that the futures really don't move that much after the market closes unless a Google's coming out and a Google misses or a Microsoft misses. You know, other than that, they can fluctuate four or five points. That's about it. What will happen, however, is this, is that as we come into the close, you're going to see more movement in the industrial averages, in the NASDAQ averages. The reason being is that future traders, you don't have to worry, you know, about where the close comes in. You get like 15 minutes after that and say, okay, what am I going to do? Am I going to stay long? Am I going to start? Am I going to cover? Am I going to be flat? Now, we're not going to have that 15 minutes. So that is going to make decisions come in before the 4 o'clock time frame, which will move markets around, I suspect, a lot more. You know, because inside the futures market, it's still liquid after 4 o'clock. Well, and in this case, now, anyone that's used to trading like that, bottom line, they're going to have to close those positions out and close those positions out earlier, which are going to move positions in a very large way. And, you know, if you do have an interest in the metals market, folks, this is the last weekend. We did this special for 1 week. This coming Tuesday is my 700th edition of the Gold Report. If you'd like to save 20% on a monthly basis for as long as you subscribe, you can do it. Today, tomorrow, Sunday, it's over Sunday night. You check it out on the front page of TFNN. And, you know, bottom line, I suspect what we're going to see is that these metals want to move. And why do they want to move? It's like the Fed's telling us. I mean, the Fed's telling me they're not going up in rates, period. I mean, I hear people even this morning saying, oh, now it's going to be December. December? Everything just changed, folks. I mean, even if you're a fundamentalist, you've got to be listening what she said. What she said is, listen, we have employment's fine in this country right now. Unemployment's fine in this country right now. You know, it's like, this is not about what's happening in this country right now. What's happening is that they're worried about the stock market. Well, the stock market's going down. They're worrying about Europe. Europe's going down. They're worrying about Asia. Asia's going down. Well, guess what? That means that rates aren't going up. And if you fundamentally go right back to rates in the rest of the world, we still have some of the highest rates in the rest of the world. Now, does that make any sense? You stay right there, folks. We're coming right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. We get, 3M is down 350. You get IBM, where is she? IBM, where are you? IBM's down 376. You got Walmart off a dollar. United Technologies is down 235. This is some big numbers out here. GE's down 53 cents. You get ExxonMobil off 210. I know what we want to look at. Let's go over the oil market. Okay, so check this out. Let's get oil up here. CLX5. Okay. CLX5. Okay, so we're at 45.12. You're backing in. We did volume today of 258,000 contracts. That's big volume. Okay, cool. Okay, so if you, oil looks to me like we're going to go after, we're at 45.11. Oil wants to go after 43.99. What I suspect you're going to probably see is that oil's going to back right into where it came off the bottom, that area about $40.56 to about $39.74. Now, what's going to be cool, folks, is this. If you back in there, and we do, and you back in with lighter volume. This way, you just let it happen. If you back in with lighter volume, what you're going to have, you're going to have a wide trading band. And oils love to trade in wide trading bands. If we go over to ExxonMobil, we take a look at ExxonMobil. Exxon's giving back $2 today. Okay, so watch this. The 17 million shares, you get an expansion of volume. Exxon came off the lows of $66, runs up to 75. The high of the low is 71.38. Now, today we're going to do 17 million shares. Just let this be. You want to see how it gets into the high of the low bar, which is the bar from the 24th. Chevron, we take a look at Chevron. So the way the exercise works, folks, is that if you get into the bar with volume, don't touch it. Don't even think about touching it. If you get into the bar, you don't have any volume, then you want to look at it, but you still need a rejection of price. With Chevron, what we're dealing with is this. Chevron is down $1.90. You're at 77.48. 75.35 is the top of the bar. The bottom of the bar is 69.58. Your swing point that Chevron's going after right now is 74.31. Now, we've done 14 million shares here. It's not going after it today, but we'll go after it Monday. The swing point's 11.4. That very well could be problematic. If it is, well, guess what? No problem. You're still waiting to see how it's going to get into the bar from the 24th. The 24th on that baby is your benchmark. That's how you want to set it up. And what I, you know, expect you're going to also see out here, you know, it's going to be, my take here is it's going to be the commodity markets that moves. There's always, I'm telling you, man, when the Fed does one thing, just something else starts moving. And if it seems to me that it's screaming right now that rates are going to stay at zero for much longer than any of us ever thought. You know, we're from 2007 right now. This is going to be a lot longer because now they're trapped. Well, it's not that necessarily that they're even trapped. The bottom line is that when you look at rates around the world, we have high rates. You know, we're 2.1 on the 10-year bond, okay? And we're the United States of America. Guess what? You go to Italy, they're at 1.7. It's like, really? Why does someone give money to Italy for less expensive than us? Go to Spain, is it 1.9? They're broke. Go to the Netherlands, that's really a trip. That's 0.8%. Sweden, 0.7%. Those are small countries, beautiful countries, but small countries. Germany, 0.6%. You can see the correlation. The correlation is that, you know, we're actually at high rates. This is Tom O'Brien, this is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming back. I will start off the first hour with the closing numbers. Dow right now is down 315 rather. S&Ps are off 34. The Nasdaq's down 70. We're going to be right back, folks.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Tom in Derry, New Hampshire. Hey, Tom, what's going on?
Mr. O'Brien, how are you today?
I'm doing great, man. How you been?
This is like old-timers week. I heard Rick from British Columbia. I'm waiting to hear Greg from Long Island.
I like that. Totally, man. Totally.
By the way, your website, unbelievable. Watching that thing change over the years. You guys are doing a bang-up job. You get great guests.
Keep
up the good work, man.
We appreciate you being out there. We never can do it without all you tigers and tigresses, Tom.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. It's a TGIF, folks. Let's make it a great one. Follow what you love, and it'll take you where you want to go. Natalie Goldberg. Yesterday's gone. Tomorrow's not here. What are you doing right now? Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We had the Dow Industrials closed down 289, NASDAQ off 66, S&P's down 27, gold contract up $21.60, trading at $1,138 an ounce. Silver up 16 cents at $15.50 an ounce. Copper down 5 pennies at down 7 pennies at $2.37 a pound. Light sweet crude down $2 at $45.21 a barrel. Bonds. You had the 10-year up 21.6, 127.31. 30-year up a full 2.5 at 155.18. Bottom line, those bonds, wide price spread, accelerated volume, they're going right back to up to those highs. King dollar. King dollar past 718 ticks, 95.33. The euro down $1.40 at 112. That's 140 ticks. And the yen flat at 119.97. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. Now, let's take a look at the world of the S&Ps. What do you have? Okay, so if we start with the SPY, folks, monster volume out here. What we had out here inside the SPY, you did 208 million shares. You're down $3.30. You're trading from the 24th of August. The high of that is 197.47. The low is 182. Now, as I've said many times, the lows spikes on the 24th of August. There was a few trades there. Bottom line, the low of the 25th is definitely real. That low is 186.92. That's where we're going. You have gone up after the dead cat bounce off the 24th. Go all the way up. Yesterday, gave it up in spades. Today, you just broke this smaller downtrend. 186.92, that's where that SPY is going to make a run for. The expansion of volume we had here today, this can be a monster ABC down, by the way, also. The NQs, three Qs, what do you have? Down $1.47 today, you've done 42 million shares. Same setup there, that wants to run down to 98.01. Right now, we're trading out at 105.40. You can expect Sunday night's going to be a wild one. Now, gold contract, what do we have with gold? Gold goes topside, has wide price spread, has the accelerated volume, all of the above. Gold right now is trading at 1138. Your swing point that is going after, which is a high volume swing, was established out there on the 24th of August. That's 1169.80. I expect you're going to get there. What gold had done, too, when we came off the lows in August 11th and 12th, the way gold broke topside, that puts gold on the agenda to get to 1234, which is the higher swing point for May 18th. First, of course, we have to get up to the 1169 area. I expect you're going to see both pretty quickly. We go over to the silver market. What do you have? You have the wide price spread, accelerated volume, also in silver. We did 44,000 contracts out here today. The swing point on silver, the first swing point is 1577. Next one, higher one, is up there at the $17.85 area. Bonds. What do we have with the bond market? You got to love this. The bond market is just absolutely wild. So we start with the 10-year. 10-year today is up 20 ticks. You're at 127.30. We have two separate high volume spike highs. As we go backward, the September 4th is the first one. That's 128.04. We did 1.2 million contracts there. Today we did a million contracts. The larger one is where we did take out on the 10-year, you took out the 30, the highs of April and the bonds. That spike is 129.10. Now, what I expect you're going to see is this. We're going to take out the 4th. We're going to get all the way up to the 24th, and we'll see what type of juice we have as we get up there. My take on this is that more than likely, bonds are going to be in play to actually get sold after a 35-year bull market in bonds. You know, we'll see. And the volume is going to dictate that, and of course the price would too, but the volume is going to dictate it. The reason why, folks, is that off the highs, three separate times we've come down with volume. And you've come right back inside with volume too, but as it gets up to the highs and test them, the volume dies. So that sets up a trading range number one, which is really great because bonds are $1,000 a point. And that range is very large. We take a look at the 30-year. What do you have with the 30-year? 30-year right now, you're trading at 155.17. That little baby is gonna make its run to 161.17. If we take a look at the continuous contract, What you have inside this continuous contract is this. The continuous contract, the highs in the continuous contract was in April 3rd, 166.27. Now, when we ran up and the 10-year took out the high, the 30-year did not. So what that means is this, is that the 30-year is going to give us more information how we come into that. And that's what's going to be the real cool thing, because your back can be against the wall, not only at that high that was generated on the 28th, but the high that was generated over there on May 1st. Why? Because that was the first time that we came down with juice inside of that market. King Dollar. What do you have with King Dollar? King Dollar, folks, is toast. Get the cream cheese out. Get the peanut butter and jelly out. Get it all out. King Dollar. What does it do? King Dollar goes down into the 24th today. It rejects lower price. And it has lighter volume. We did 35,000 contracts. Yesterday, it went down with 48,000. What I expect you to see is that King Dollar is going to try to get into 95.57, about 200 ticks up from here. It'll die on the vine once again. Why? Two different reasons. The larger reason is that when King Dollar was trying to get into highs, just going back to the September 3rd level, it couldn't even reach its swing point. The swing point on King Dollar is 98.74. King Dollar only could run into 96.92. Larger still is the amount of volume that we have on from the 24th. When you look at the 24th, what we haven't got tested yet, and this is the key in this whole deal, what hasn't been tested, if I go back in the contract that was trading, is the high volume swing low that I believe was 145,000. Yeah, 143,000 contracts we did. That's going to get tested. That's the bottom line. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. And if you are in the metal market, folks, this is the last weekend that I'm special on my gold report. You get 20% off right in the front page of TFNN over the weekend. It's my 700th edition coming out this Tuesday morning. You stay right there, folks. We're coming right back. Dow Industrials finished down 289. NASDAQ off 66. S&P's down 26. We're going to be right back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit TFNN.com.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today.
An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls.
Now.
Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. Dow finished down 289, NASDAQ up 66, S&P's down 26. As we do each and every Friday, we get our man, Mr. Dave White, our technology expert right here at TFNN. And don't forget, folks, at TFNN, you can get all that programming right on your cell phone, tfnn.mobi. Dave has a great show every trading day, 2 to 3 Eastern Standard Time. Also has a couple great newsletters. You can test drive those newsletters by coming over to our website at TFNN, going to newsletters. You can go into trading newsletters, and you can take the path of least resistance. You can also go under investment newsletters and get the Tech Insider. You can test drive both of those 30 days absolutely free. And so the first slide we got, the end of WWW.
What's the end of the World Wide Web.
Okay.
Silicon Valley is kind of going nuts this week.
Yeah.
And they're going nuts over the super decline of ads being sent through web browsers.
Okay.
With the advent of, especially this week, several of the ad blocking software went to number one in the App Store for Apple phones.
Okay. Because they put that in there, right? Right. The new iOS allows you to block ads, right?
Right. And it went to number one and number two and number three.
You know what's so funny about that? This morning I'm getting coffee at Starbucks and two people were beside me. One was explaining to the other how to put it on.
And so literally since about Tuesday, everybody's been freaking out because, of course, the mother's milk is advertising pretty much for everything.
Right.
And now everybody this week, since most everybody in the world was in technology, was in and around Dreamforce, the convention from Salesforce this week.
Yes.
Everybody was in Silicon Valley. They're all talking about the one thing, and there's a kind of an echo chamber effect between one person. So they built it up a lot. But even interestingly enough, I think behind the curtains, something interesting happened with Apple, because the guy that wrote the number one seller in the App Store took it off about 3:15. I mean, I'm getting ready to walk out the door and race over here for the show, and boom, that was the headline. I'm taking it off the iOS. And if people don't understand, let me just explain ad blockers. When you go to a web page, it may actually show you the web page from the company you're looking at.
Right.
But at the same time, there may be 10, 15 different websites it goes to get the ads from different websites, and it kind of slows down the machine, and of course means that you're moving a lot more data. So if you've got a cell phone, and even if it's 4G, instead of waiting for 10 seconds for everything to load, it loads in 2 seconds, and pretty fast. So,
and the ads follow you. Like, you know, I remember a few years ago when I first started, I mean, if I go look up anything, you know, as soon as you pull up another browser, bottom line, you're getting ads for the last thing you pulled up.
Right, but it's all about, now the thought is this the end of the World Wide Web with a browser and moving only to apps that can force you to look at all these particular ads?
Okay.
And that's what yesterday Facebook saw all this and said, we're going to offer you a deal where you can pay for people that only see your ads instead of the ones that you think might see your ads but have an ad blocker. So they're going to guarantee that the people see your ads. And of course, they can do that by forcing you to go through their app, which you can't control.
So check this out. This is really cool, folks, okay, that we're talking about this, okay? So picture, you know, we are in the advertising business, okay? So, you know, we're in the newsletter business, the advertising business, the education business. And we got one of our proposals that came in this week had to do with, and this has always drove me crazy, because this is what it is. As a small company, what happens, folks, is that our ads actually get shown out there. You know, you hear them on the thing, you can see them on the web. What happens is that if you're a Procter & Gamble, there, and I know where they're advertising, and over 24% of their ads, to actually, except a third, and this is GM, they're paying for things, and it's billions and billions of dollars that they never get seen because they're below the drop, right? Well, this is the first proposal I saw that they're looking for everything above the drop, and that's why they came in, which was really cool. I'm saying to myself, now, it means that you can sell less, but it's not like we, you know, sell a lot, okay? Right. So it's pretty cool, because so that's happening. That's a different aspect, but it really isn't, because these companies now are starting to pay attention to, hey, am I paying for something that people don't see?
Well, it's like Fios. I've got Fios internet, but I also have Fios cable.
Okay.
And the cable box will tell them whether or not I watch what I recorded within within a week.
Yeah.
If it doesn't come out in a week, it doesn't go into the reporting. So I can watch it in 2 weeks from now, and I can see the same Buick ad.
Yeah.
But they don't count it if I don't watch it within the week.
Okay.
Now, the other thing is they can tell and will tell the advertiser whether I fast-forwarded it and didn't see their ad at all.
That's pretty cool, man. I like that.
So the whole idea of whether or not you get advertising as a service and whether or not we're going to go to apps that force you to do this. And so that's why everybody's talking about the end.
What's the deal with, you know, I was reading about this morning about the aspect of, you know, Apple is the one that had basically pushed this.
Right.
Okay. And it was having, like, saying that Google really wasn't worrying about it. You know, that Google understands that those are coming, and that's their bread and butter, though.
It is, but to them and to an advertiser,
yeah,
the fact that you know you can target a particular individual
right.
knows that if they're interested in it, they will probably watch that ad or do something else.
Right.
Now, we talked about it maybe 2 months or 3 months ago, before Google actually had kind of a good earnings cycle. And just in the last 4 to 6 weeks before that earnings cycle, they started forcing me to watch all these forced ads before I could watch anything on YouTube.
Really?
Right. And that's when they kind of had a pop. And everybody thought, well, where'd all this money come from?
Yeah.
It came from forcing you to watch this video, and they wouldn't play the video if you wanted to. Now, since then, I check my YouTube channels that have a lot to do with technology every night, and I'll watch them. But now, literally, it's probably 1 for 3.
Okay.
I have to watch one of their ads, and I have to watch 10 seconds of it. And then I can click, you know.
Yeah, because that's when they get paid, right?
Right.
It is 10 seconds. That's what it is.
It's the 10 seconds, and that's it. So the whole idea is whether or not any of these companies in maybe a year or 2 years or 5 years will actually have, it'll be hooked up to the internet, but it will not be the World Wide Web. It won't be the browser experience. You'll be forced to use their app to get their content so that they can guarantee advertisers that you see
well, you know, it's
their
wild.
Product.
And you being a programmer, I'm sure you know this, is that in 97, 98, I remember I had a guy in my office and he was convinced, and I'm sure the guy's a multi-billionaire now, I hope he is, he was writing middleware then. They called it middleware then. And I didn't know what it was, but he's explained to me. He says, no, this is going to go like this. And I lost track of him. Do you know what I mean? But that's pretty cool, because that's what you're saying. Middleware is an app, right?
Yes. Basically,
yeah, okay, right.
And some people call it, it's called a thin client.
Yeah.
And that is, you have some really small device being fed by a very big device that does all the processing, figuring it out. And that was like an Oracle thing, and he was predicting that in 1985. It's just taken 30 years.
It totally makes sense, because this guy was at Oracle Database.
Yeah, they were big on that idea of the thin client.
It was, because we were right down the street from them.
Yeah.
Dave White, Tom O'Brien, you stay right there, folks. We'll come right back. Dow finished down 289, NASDAQ off 66, S&P's down 26. We're going to be right back.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
This coming Tuesday, September 22nd, Tom O'Brien will publish the 700th issue of his weekly newsletter, The Gold Report. It's amazing to think that Tom started his newsletter over 13 years ago when gold was trading under $300 an ounce. To celebrate the 700th issue, you can sign up right now at a 20% savings off the regular monthly price, and you can lock in that low rate for as long as you remain a subscriber. The Gold Report is Tom's weekly newsletter covering the gold market as well as a variety of gold mining equities. The Gold Report is published every Tuesday afternoon with a market update sent out to subscribers on Monday mornings. Tom will walk you through what's going on in the gold and metals market each week, as well as providing specific buy and sell recommendation on the mining equities themselves. Now is the perfect time to sign up for the Gold Report. The 700th issue is published Tuesday, and that's when this sale ends, so act now. TFNN has just announced a brand new morning lineup that is geared specifically for traders in this volatile traders market. Every morning at 8 a.m., John Logan starts things off with his daily program, The Global Market Pulse. At 9 a.m., Larry Pesavento trades the market during the market open Monday through Friday on Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom O'Brien hosts the Money Masters for the hour, and Basil Chapman hosts his Tiger Technicians Hour at 11 a.m. From 8 a.m. till noon every market day, these traders are with you as they provide up-to-the-second market information so that you can make the most educated and profitable trades possible. The new TFNN morning lineup is happening right now. Tune in to see for yourself what kind of actionable trading discussion they have each morning, Monday through Friday, starting at 8 a.m., live only on Tiger TV at TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. We appreciate your growling and prowling with us out here. We got our man, Mr. Dave White, with us. We are talking technology and Microsoft right. Surface.
Right. Their next versions and, of course, all the third-party people that are making new laptops. Now, we talked about some of the new stuff, like the camera that can tell twins apart and a lot of the new features that are in the new chips from Intel.
Yeah.
Anyway, this is going to be the rollout with the computers with new functions that only work in Windows 10.
So that'll check be this October out. 6th. Last night we're out eating, right? And I'm looking at this table. I'm watching this table, folks. There are only a couple tables over for us. And I could tell that there, you know, some kind of a party was going on, right? Well, sure enough, it was the person's birthday, right? And what I didn't see is that the husband, okay, had a Surface right there. And guess what? He took the Surface, giving it to the waiter, says, okay, you got to take our picture out. And I'm cracking up, man, because that's a big device right. in order to, but guess what? They must like it.
If you got one, I guess you can use it. The guy probably has a phone with him. He could have used the phone.
No, maybe
he just had it out, right?
When I saw it, my head was spinning because I said to myself, you got to be kidding me. This is what I was thinking. I was thinking that he's a Microsoft person. And because he wasn't a phone person, all of a sudden he realized I can take a picture. Do you know what
I
mean? Which,
I don't know. Yeah. I see some more of them as time goes along. It's probably still,
it's not for pictures. No, I understand that.
Yeah, it's still probably the best unit, but it looks like Microsoft never wanted to get into the business of making them. They had to because, of course, Dell and the rest of them weren't keeping up with Apple and the laptops.
Right.
Now, of course, Apple's kind of with their new iPad trying to up against that. But
they're going to get in that medical business, right? I mean, that's for medical records.
But it's nowhere close to what these devices are like as far as hardware. I mean, these are years down the line, even though Apple has a very specific function. These are much better. Anyway, you're going to see a lot of these new features come out on October 6th. And, of course, we talked last week about August shipping on the 22nd. So
Office,
the new version Office, which is next week. And, of course, they're on the subscription basis. So things should be at least interesting for Microsoft over the next couple of weeks. Now,
Chromecast.
Right. Apple came out with their new Apple TV last week.
Yeah.
So now this week we have Chromecast leaking the new versions of their device for this fall. We also have Amazon
Fire TV
leaking their new stuff. Now, there's a little bit more known about the Amazon. It's going to be a 4K device.
Okay.
So you'll be able to stream, theoretically, if you have a strong enough internet connection, in 4K. I don't know how much stuff. It's going to be pay or what. But that they have that. Chromecast has theirs, and of course, according to the leaks, it's still going to be a $30 device, where we're talking $150 or $200 for the Apple TV.
Right.
So they're going to be fairly inexpensive devices. This one from the Fire TV is going to be $99. So it's going to be...
Now, the Chromecast and the Fire TV, even the Apple TV, you need that if you don't have a TV that's already, like, streaming, right? Like, my TVs are streaming already.
Yeah, but The problem is that once the TV's made, the apps really don't change. You can kind of upload stuff, but the technology is stuck.
Okay.
Right now, I've got a Chromecast.
Yeah.
I buy a new Chromecast, plug it into the TV I have, which is not smart, and I've got all the new features. Now, new features on this are going to be a ton of apps that they're adding in the store to do things like Spotify and new features, and they're selling other apps to other companies so that you can use your monitor through their device.
Right.
And at least
so that's the way to look at it. You look at that the Chromecast is a computer and just using a monitor. That's how you got to look at it.
Right.
I got it. Okay. Cool.
The same thing with Fire TV. The difference is though, you know, even you just wait a year. And everything doubles in speed and memory. And if you buy a TV with everything in it, then you're just slowly going away, right?
I don't think so, because I think I got a Samsung, and I think
you can upgrade upgrade the software. You can't upgrade the hardware.
No, but it's just an internet connection. You just hit it.
Right, but like this one?
Yeah.
Twice the buffer speed.
Okay.
Okay, it's gonna do both new features for both interlaced and non-interlaced.
Okay.
It's going to have additional things where you can interact
with
it.
No, I'm with it for $30, man. Give me a break.
So the idea is that as hardware changes, to me, this is a lot better than buying a new TV every few years to get new hardware in your TV, right?
Oh, no doubt.
So, and the same thing, Apple TV, same thing.
So go get those Chromecast, folks. You can watch us on Tiger TV.
Chromecast.
Just go to TFNN.
Yeah.
That's simple.
Chromecast or Fire TVs.
Right.
I've got both of them. And if you've got Prime, of course, you get a bunch of free movies with Amazon. Now, they have a thing called a Fire Stick, which is like $40 with a little remote, just like this one. And then they've got this bigger one, which is $99, which they call Fire TV. But both of them are pretty good.
Audi and Porsche.
The big auto show in Europe rolled out this week.
Okay.
And they are showing extremely fast recharging electric vehicles. Now, both Audio and...
EVs, electronic vehicles. I got it. Okay, cool.
Audio and Porsche have a difference between what is traditional here in the United States, and that is that they've wired their batteries up for 800-volt plus operation, Tesla kind of set the bar at about 400 volts here in the United States. Well, being at least somewhat technical in electronics, what you find out is the higher voltage you go to, the faster you can recharge. So this is going to recharge at about 3/4 of the same time that it takes the Tesla to recharge. Now, both of these are very high-end $100,000 cars, right?
Yep.
They're like Tesla. It's not going to be cheap.
Tesla S, right.
Right. But they are now going to have a lot more competition, especially in Europe, since that's where these cars are made.
Well, and I don't know if you saw it, because this happened late in the day, but what happened with Volkswagen, that's intense, man. So Volkswagen, folks, has been accused by the EPA of putting software inside like 13 million cars, circumvented the penalty. What did it say, 19 billion? No, more than that.
It's
somehow 86 billion, I think. It's 36,000 a car.
I know that, but just
thinking that the aspect, I suspect, well, hey, we'll find out what happens.
I didn't get the chance to read exactly what it was supposed to do.
What happens is this, is that you, I don't know the whole thing, but I know that when you go get an emissions test, it's electronic,
and
what they did is that what they're saying they did is that a piece of software that they put in the car circumvents the amount
EPA
of
regulations.
It circumvents the amount of decimals or whatever you call those that are going into that the thing is reading.
So
which is really a trick,
man. So when you get a test, it's cheating.
Yeah.
We used to have that down here where they put the thing up your tailpipe and tested it, and that went away 15 years ago?
Yeah,
something
like
that.
Gee, in Boston, you just give the guy, the inspections are $5, you give him $10, and they put the sticker on.
Yeah. But down here, we used to have to go in and get it tested.
Right.
Right. And that's the way it is in California and other states.
Right.
So the question is, what's going on that? Bitcoin.
Bitcoin, yep.
Bitcoin became a commodity this week.
Oh, really?
And I don't think a lot of people have thought the implications of a commodity. Can you buy a commodity without being signed up with a broker dealer?
You can buy a commodity, but what you can't. Let's talk about this.
This
is going to be a good one, folks, because what just happened is that this big gold contractor that when we had the exchange we're going against just got indicted.
Yeah.
So, Dave White, Tom O'Brien, you stay right there. We'll come right back. Dow Industrials finished down 289, NASDAQ off 66, S&P's down 26. We're going to be right back.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a 2-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
Take your phone calls
now.
Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dave White, Tom O'Brien. Don't forget, folks, this is the last weekend. If you'd like to be in the metals market, my gold report, the 700th edition, is coming out this coming Tuesday. We have a special that's going on this week only. You can save 20% off your monthly subscription for as long as you get it, right in the front page of TFNN. We're talking Bitcoin, and this is so cool, Dave, okay? So why don't you read what you have out here?
Okay, the U.S. Commodities Futures Trading Commission issued its first action against an unregistered Bitcoin options trading platform, ordering the startup to cease operations and basically settle their case, close the doors,
right,
and give us cash.
Right.
And apparently this company did it. Now, I forget the name of the company. I never heard of them before.
Right.
But by declaring it a commodity,
yeah,
and anything that you do with a commodity,
right,
I suspect the same laws that you have to do with a commodity will apply. That means that you will have to sign up with a broker-dealer.
That's right.
And, of course, Bitcoin, to a great extent, is about being anonymous.
Right.
And you're no longer anonymous once you've got a broker-dealer filing paperwork for every time that you move coins in and out of a Bitcoin system.
Well, so what you have is this. So check this out, folks. And if you don't know this, the CTFC, folks, is one of the strongest regulatory agencies in the world. The CTFC is 10 times stronger than the SEC, okay? They're is about as intense as you get. So in the United States, there's no doubt what this does immediately, just as Dave said, that if that exchange is in the United States, well, you know, bottom line, you are going to be registered. And if you and I are buying that off an exchange in the United States, we're also going to be registered. And the next key is will be that, if you make money, no matter how you make money, you have to basically pay taxes on it. So
right, but if you are somebody that is in the shadows using Bitcoin,
right? Well, they'll just buy it offshore.
Right, but guess what?
What?
Now you're violating the law. Before, they really couldn't say that by you buying something.
No,
with Bitcoin,
you wouldn't be. You and I wouldn't be. It's the broker dealer. If you and I decided to set up an exchange here,
right,
and we did that, we'd be breaking the law. The person that's buying, they can't stop you or me,
right,
from buying anywhere outside the country. We can't.
You have to report it, right?
You have to report if you make money on it.
Or even if you lose money on it.
No, not if it's less than $10,000.
Okay.
Yeah.
My thought, though, is the way that I read a lot more of this,
yeah,
was that this is the way to get their foot in the door of literally controlling it.
So I agree with you. Oh, there's no doubt. Yes.
So they are after this. And, of course, this comes on the heel of Tuesday of the big company that went bust in Japan, Mt. Gox, that was the biggest exchange.
Right.
And he's been charged with stealing $2.7 billion of his own company's money.
Right. And there's no doubt, you know, I heard you talking about the blockchain, and the blockchain's a big deal. This is going to be, I mean, you know, you saw that, folks, the person that started the derivative business, basically Jamie Dimon, I think, gave her marching orders. Now, you go get this blockchain going, okay? Because Jamie Dimon from J.P. Morgan had already given a speech that he was worried. He's really worried about not only Bitcoin. He's worried about all these internet startups that are lending money, and he should be, okay? Because you know, J.P. Morgan, you know, forget it, man. These other people. I'm not defending Bitcoin, but these other lenders are bringing. It's not that they're bringing prices down, because those other lenders, folks, are really. They're hard money lenders, really, okay? But the aspect is it's going to take money away from the banks.
Well, the interesting part that I think will change the stock market with blockchains.
Yes.
Blockchains, by the way, are kind of like having a ledger for your business. But everybody has a copy of the ledger.
Exactly.
And if everybody's doesn't match, nothing goes forward.
Well, and one of the, you know, if you look at STT, I mean, they got to be so scared. State Street Corporation. Yeah. State Street is the largest institutional. Let's just look at the stock for a second, because this is, they make the bulk of their money by doing back office paperwork.
Right.
They got to worry.
There's two things that I change. One is back office paperwork for the markets.
Yeah.
The other one is I'm on the FINRA.
Yes.
Email list. Right.
Right.
So every day, we're finding these people $9.5 million. We're finding these people $50 million.
Right.
We're finding these companies $75 million for blind short selling.
Right.
If they actually did this in the market,
right,
you couldn't get away with blind short selling, because
right,
everything would have to add up. You'd have to, by the end of the day, the blockchains would have to come out.
Right.
And if they didn't come out, that would be it. And my comment, I think I was talking to Andy on the radio about it, was what would happen when Wall Street can't lie? Because
right,
this literally would mean that people couldn't pull that out.
That's why Jamie Dimon has to control it. Right? No. I agree.
That's not a bad idea.
I agree.
There's two parts of it. The part you're talking about is the back office.
Yep.
And I remember reading...
No, I think that's a great part.
I remember reading Jesse Livermore's book.
Right.
And in there he talks about sometimes when the market got busy, they wouldn't know what happened for 2 weeks. The paperwork would still be going on. They'd close the market down just to catch up with the previous weeks because it was so bad before computers. Now it isn't that bad.
Except in the high yield bond market.
Yeah.
The high yield bond market, folks, it takes 2 weeks to 3.5 weeks to actually, if Dave and I did a trade, the trade would be done, but guess what? If he was selling to me, I wouldn't get that paperwork for 2.5 to 3 weeks. If I was selling to you, you wouldn't get it. And that's a mess. And that's where the problem comes in, that ETF structure of the high yield ones. Not treasuries, but different ballgame, but there's no doubt. And, you know, that'll get changed ASAP. So Mt. Gox.
Right, that's the company that went went belly up.
Yep.
And everybody was looking to figure out where that money came. Of course, the CEO said that he'd been hacked and all the money disappeared.
Right.
Well,
right from the get-go, it was kind of like, yeah.
Well, it's unclear how he's being prosecuted and whether or not it's Japan or the United States that's prosecuting. All you find is this kind of real nebulous thing that he's been arrested, and of course he's been arrested in Japan, but is it he been arrested for the United States, or has he been arrested for Japan?
Well, I'm sure all these central banks are worrying about Bitcoin. They gotta be, you know?
Or a Bitcoin thing.
Right.
I think it's gonna be a lot like the first computer that came along, the Osborne's and the CPM 80s and the Trash 80 computers that came along in the 70s. Then Apple and PCs and everything came along. Bitcoin is probably going to be thought of as that technology. The companies that are probably in it now, I don't think, probably survive that
long. It's the technology, right?
Right.
There's no doubt. It's using the technology for other uses.
Right.
The finger hood is good?
The fiber hood.
Oh, the fiber hood, sorry.
The fiber hood. You always hear these ads where they call you up and say, we'll be here between 8 and 5 p.m. to hook up your cable today, right?
Okay.
Well, we find out that it doesn't have to be that way. Google has mastered it, and they are getting absolutely rave reviews for the people that are, when they tell you they come in at a time, they come at that time. And basically it says, Google would like you to know that its installers are on time 96% of the time. The average hold time on the phone is a shade above 30 seconds. And of course, if you go to Comcast, it's 30 minutes or an hour, and maybe they get to you in the next week or so.
Yeah, and they wreck your house, unless you're right there.
Yes.
You stay right there, folks. Dave White, Tom O'Brien, appreciate you growling and prowling. We're going to be coming right back. You can check out Dave's newsletter. Go to our website at TFNN. Go into newsletters. Go into trading newsletters. The Path Least Resistance test drive at 30 days. Absolutely free. We're coming right back, folks.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will
will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and the Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income, much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage, or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at tfnn.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dave White, Tom O'Brien, appreciate you growling and prowling with us. You know, so when you're talking fiber and Google, Google's getting more aggressive now into cities, too.
Yeah, they're in about 12 cities now.
Okay.
Probably going to go to about 36 cities in the next 2 years.
And we're just talking off the air a little. The cities they're going to... really not Fios cities, though, because the Fios is the number one run out there, so they're going where the service is slower, right?
Right. If you get Comcast, you've got about a third of the speed I have at home.
Yep.
With Fios.
Right.
So if you're Google, you just go to where the service
which
is
so
the
smart.
Worst, right?
I know. Right.
And
right.
That's what they're doing. So the primary cities like Austin, Texas,
yes.
Where they were, you know, treating people horribly.
And it's a big tech center.
Yeah,
huge.
Big tech center. But they're going to a lot of those places where the service was the absolute pits first.
Yeah.
And, of course, the way that they go into the cities and ask people if they want to be it,
sure.
Sign up before they ever get started.
Right.
They already know whether they're going to be able to make money or at least break even.
Exactly. Huge.
And so they've got a great thing going.
Oh, it is.
They're going to put a lot of heat on Comcast, Time Warner.
Compared to even like a Fios, it's like 10 times faster or 100 times faster? What is it?
My Fios connection is about 3 times faster than the fastest I can get from Comcast.
And how much is Google faster than Fios?
10 times.
Wow. Okay, that's cool. Yeah, right.
Yeah, I'm getting about a little less than 100 megabits per second, and I'd get a gigabit per second from Fios. So, yes, I would love to
We all would. Right.
Yeah. It's what you're going to need for 4K video.
Okay.
And one of the reasons that Google is pushing this is to push other companies like Comcast into competing, because they do want to get to these 4K video screens. They do want to get to being able to scale out a lot of applications. They're going to need a lot of data.
Well, you know what's wild is that, I don't know if you saw the ad, but one of our TV stations around here, folks, just got a helicopter. First time I seen it was last night. And it's a whole HD helicopter.
Yeah.
And now they're showing the pictures. It's insane. It's like you're right there.
Oh, they're beautiful.
That's crazy, man. Impossible mission.
Right. Xerox PARC, which is the birthplace of just about everything we use today.
What happened to poor Xerox? That's crazy. I know.
They had a bunch of people who could never figure out what to do with all the neat stuff they had.
Wow.
But this is very interesting. It's kind of like we were old enough to know, watch the original Mission Impossible TV series.
Right.
At the end of every, the beginning of the show, the tape would burn up, right?
Right, right.
Well, a lot of people figured out that without physically shredding a lot of electronics, it is possible to recover lots of data.
Yes.
So what they did, and DARPA did, was literally make chips that will self-destruct, just like just like back in the original Mission Impossible, that if they at any time you want to destroy everything on it. And all I could think of is
that's amazing.
You know,
the feds are gonna go crazy on that.
Well, I was thinking more of that you would think about. Remember that everything used to be on flash paper.
Yes.
And everybody, if you came in, you just hit it with a match.
Yeah.
And poof,
and
it
the
was
movies
gone.
Anyway. Right.
I don't know if people really used it or
not.
But certainly that is kind of the
same. The bookie
used it. The bookies, used it. But anyway, so now they've got a lot of these chips, and they're going to use them for keys in military applications so that they can get the key back and destroy it and know without shredding it that instantly at that second it's destroyed.
That's pretty wild. So these will be out pretty soon?
Within about the next year, they want them for the military and the CIA and that stuff right now.
Wow.
So, I'm going to assume it's going to be into the market in the next year. And
Tesla and lithium batteries.
We've talked about it. We don't have enough time to finish up here.
Okay.
But we've talked about trying to get all the lithium they need from Chile.
Yeah.
They made a deal. They're going to start their own mines in Nevada
to
get their own lithium so they can't be held hostage by the Chileans.
Unreal.
Chileans.
Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it. Take ownership of it and fly with it. Have a great weekend. Safe weekend. Dave and I rested.
Check out my newsletter under investment newsletters.
Look forward to speaking to you Monday. Have a great one, folks. Have a safe one.
You
Thanks,
bet.
Dave.